Hey guys, today we're going to do something a little bit different. Today I'm going to introduce you to all my minions of dogs. AKA all the background noise you hear in a lot of my videos. You know, my alarm system, my whatever you want to call it, but they're always up to something. So I thought maybe we'd make a little video and about my many rescue dogs. And I do have a passion for rescuing dogs, and I would probably have 100 dogs if I had the means to foster them till I could find them homes. But I don't, but I do what I can. So let's go meet my dogs. Ready for chaos.
Hey guys.
Let me introduce you. This is our OG S Digger. He's world famous. Some people confuse him with a pot-bellied pig. He's a trans species, I guess. This little gal, Belle, Jeff dropped her off and insisted we take her. She belonged to an old couple, 80-something years old. One lady passed, and 2 months later, the husband passed, and they were going to take her to the pound. That's Belle. Charlie over there, we don't know what his story is. He came from Victorville. He was a last-minute death row rescue. And not Victorville. Anyway, somewhere over in the Inland Empire. And they brought him to Ojai, and I took him after I lost Autumn last year, my Springer. Well, that's Rocky. Now, okay, Rocky's story is he came from a hoarding situation, a person that had 80 dogs, and he was in the joint for over 9 months. Nobody was going to take him, so my wife said, we got room for one more. So we went in and said, give us a dog that absolutely nobody wants and who's a little bit older that no one will ever take. So there he is, and we call him like the wild animal. He's like a wild animal. He's like a jackal. He's never had any attention like a normal dog, never bonded. When we go for a walk, he is absolutely reminds me of a coyote, the way his senses are, the way he reacts. He can never let his guard down. He's always just aware of everything. Guards his food. He probably had to fight for every scrap. It's kind of sad, but you know, maybe in time he'll come around. Angel's story is when my wife was a crisis counselor working with troubled youth, one of her students came and said, can you watch our dog for the weekend because my parents are going to jail and we don't want to take him to the pound. So we said, we'll take him for the weekend. That was in 2009, so it's kind of been a long weekend. So that's our 5 we have right now. We lost 4 last year.
Four.
We lost Edison, Autumn, Grizz, and Missy. And now we replaced them with Charlie, Belle, and Rocky. So I guess I had 6 dogs before, but right now I only have 5. So anyway, I keep thinking we might have room for one more little chihuahua. I want to say something though for serious. Rescue a dog or a cat. God, they didn't do nothing wrong. Someone took them home and didn't make the commitment. And when you make the commitment, keep the commitment. Don't just get one and because it's inconvenient, you get rid of it. I don't understand that. Because, you know, all they want is to love you and like you. And they always like you even when you're having the worst day ever. They're always there for you. So that's my tip for today.